Start by going to the effects panel and search transform. Click and drag it to a text clip. Head over to effects controls and uncheck use composition shutter angle. Change shutter angle to 360. Now make sure you play it is at the start of your text clip. Then click the stopwatch next to scale and change the scale value to 0. Now move 5 frames forward using your right arrow key. Then change the scale value to 120. Now move 3 frames forward and change it to 95. Move 3 frames again and change the scale to 100. You should now see a really good pop effect. To make the pop effect even smoother, select all your keyframes, right-click on one of them, and choose Continuous Bezier. As you can see, the pop effect looks really good. To make it easier to understand, you can zoom in into the keyframes and scroll through the clip. The first and second keyframe make the pop effect, while the third and fourth make the bounce effect. So, to adjust the bounce effect, we can select all the keyframes and move them closer to each other. We have now a faster animation. Now, so you don't have to do this on every text clip, you can simply go up to Transform, right-click, then go to Save to Preset. You can name it to whatever you want, then click OK. You can now always find it under the Effects panel, and then going to Presets. As you can see, the pop effect is there, but you can also search for it. Now, if I delete the keyframes that I created to remove the pop effect, you can simply click and drag the effect to your text clip, and it should automatically create the keyframes we need.